Hi friends, Chandrasekhar here again. We are into the third of the series of lectures in which I had promised to talk something about Jaimini Sutras or Jaimini astrology system or Upadesha Sutra, whatever you call it. It is part of the same traditional astrology. It focuses more on a certain part of it. And as I have already explained in the earlier lectures, so what we are doing is, we are trying to understand the concepts. We have seen the Rashi Drushtis, how they operate, what must be the principle behind it. Then in the next lecture, I talked about the Argalas and how they operate and what must be the reason of calling them Argalas. And what in my opinion is more like, where is the convergence of the two systems? The names might be different, but ultimately, what is being said is almost one and the same. The results are almost similar. Then, now we will go for the third part, the Charakaraka, about which Jaimini does talk at length. And we must also remember that he has also given the Sthirakaraka. So, it is not as if he is only talking about Charakaraka and nothing else is being talked about. That is also being talked about. Maybe in a different manner, but we must remember that Parashara has also more or less said the same thing, though we assume that Sthirakarakas are only certain and nothing else. Read Brihat Parashara also in depth sometimes so that you understand that these are opinions of the sages. Then over time, perhaps due to certain experiences that the sages and the acharyas gathered, certain grahas came to be connected with the Sthirakarakas instead of other grahas which were suggested. Not that those who were suggested just as a whim. No, they have their own principles. Perhaps if I remember right in the lecture on Sthirakarakas that I gave, I have mentioned it. So, but we will again repeat it here for the sake of understanding what Jaimini also said. So here we will talk about the concept of Charakarakas. Now the problem is, we have got Sthirakarakas, we have got Bhavakarakas, we have got individual grahas who rule over certain things, so they also are Karakas for certain things. All that we have seen. So what is the necessity of having another set of Karakas, which is Charakarakas? Now the logic behind it, if I understand right, is that people are born at different time. Why would the same planet indicate only one thing for everybody? So what is that is exactly what is Sthirakaraka. This must have arisen in the minds of the sages, and they thought, is there something more to it? And then, as we were perhaps, I think I have talked about Guru and Saturn and having larger footprint, it must have been thought that if a planet tenants a Rashi for a longer time, then it is bound to that Rashi always represents some Bhava with respect to the birth time of the Jataka. So that Bhava or that planet must have some more influence on that person. This ought to be the logic, and I think that was the logic. So, in sutra form, he says, Atma adhika kala adivir nabhogaha, which means a planet which has spent maximum number of degrees and minutes, etc., in a Rashi is called the Atma Karaka. Now, we must remember that even in, I think, Hurasar, there is a mention. Brihat Parashavi, of course, has the mention about the Chara Atma Karakas and Chara Karakas as such. Even Kalidas, I think he is not the same Kavi Kalidas, the great poet, but some other Kalidas, somebody known as Kalidas from south of India, who has written Uttar Kalamruta, also mentions it. He only calls it Adhika Graha. Perhaps because it says Atma Adhika Kaladivir Nabhogaha, So that may be, or adhik means anyway more, and so maximum number of degrees a planet has spent in a Rashi, and he has more sort of a footprint in that particular bhava, and so he has certain additional qualities. So he is likely to influence the confidence, the personality of the Jataka more than anybody else. This must be the reason behind designating the Charakaraka. So they are additional tools. So whenever something we are going to analyze, look at all those things, the Lord of the Lagna, Lord of the Bhava itself, the Karaka for the Bhava, planets aspecting, occupying that Bhava, causing damage or adding to its strength. And additionally, if you want, you can also look at the Charakaraka connected with that Bhava. So that will give you a much better idea of what is likely to happen. Now this has to be tested again and again and again on charts before one thinks of just blindly applying it. This is my advice to all astrologers. I hope I am not boring you by giving the homilies, but I can't restrain myself. I have seen too many people looking at one chart and deciding this is a principle, and then they get very disappointed when they see that on another chart it doesn't apply. So we see that Atma Adhikakala Devira Nobhoga is the sutra which says the planet with the maximum degrees spent in Rashi is the Atma Karaka. Then the sage goes on to say Saptanam Ashtanam Va. There can be 7, they can be 8. Why? So if we again go to Brihat Parashri also to find out what that sage has also said, because all these are converging centers. Jaimini himself has said Huradaya Siddhaha. So Brihat Parashri says Saptar Avyadi Shanyantan Ravantan Vashtava Sakkaka. He says how many planets are to be considered. So he says normally from Ravi, that is Sun, to Saturn, these 7 are to be considered to gain the title, if I may call it, of a Charakaraka. But sometimes Rahu is also to be considered as a number 8, planet which can gain the position of a Charakaraka. And when does this happen? That is something which must be understood. Now he says, Anshe Samo Graha Graho Dovched. When two planets have similar degrees, then he says, Rahuantan Chintayet Tada. At that time, think of Rahu. Where? Because when two planets have identical degrees, their Karakatvas merge. So they will get the same Karakatva. The next Karakatva will naturally fall vacant, which is occupied by Rahu. This is what the great Parashar has said, and though not specifically said by the sage Jaimini in his sutras, the very sutra Saptanam Ashtanam Va certainly indicates that, because he said sometimes it happens. Okay. Then the problem again arises whether Rahu is to be taken as the Atma Karaka. If you ask me, I think no. Rahu by its very nature needs somebody, some planet, some bhava to express himself. Is the basic concept of Rahu. Okay. Then if we look at the things in depth, we will see that Parashara has also said that in case of Atma Karaka, see whether the degrees are similar. If degrees are similar, then see the planet which has more kalas, that is the minutes. Okay. If minutes are also identical, then look at the vikalas, the seconds. The planet which is more in seconds will be called the Atmakaraka. Obviously, go on doing like this. The one with the maximum, even part of that vikala, would be the Atmakaraka, and then also he says ki de tancha samye kala adhikya grahyo naivatma karaka. So only because similar degrees are there, you cannot call a planet as Atmakaraka. The Buddha means the intelligent people don't accept that. And which is saying that when two Karakas merge, the next stage comes to Rahu by itself indicates that even assuming that in a very complex scenario, if even the minutes, the seconds, the microseconds, everything is same for two planets, they will merge into Atmakaraka and the next stage will come to Rahu. So Rahu, to my mind, cannot be Atmakaraka, but there are some very learned astrologers who think that Rahu can become Atmakaraka. About Rahu, obviously, since this is about spending of time or degree in a Rashi, what is to be done is Rahu's Rashis are to be deducted from 30 because it enters in the reverse direction. Isn't it? Rahu enters from the 30 degrees and goes on to 0 degree and then out of it to the next one. So naturally, if he is in 29 degrees, he has only spent 1 degree in that particular Rashi. So please remember this. Now, next riddle comes, if I may say so. Now there are again the Jaimini Sutra or Upadesha Sutra had many, these are all manuscripts which are available, the Rishis are not there, there is no recording like we are doing now, and so nobody knows what was said, and most of it was carried by memory. Sometimes people forget, sometimes they remember, sometimes shlokas are added and whatever. So in certain editions, even of BPHS, in that is Brihat Parashara Shastra, certain editions talk about the 8 Charakarakas including Pita, whereas I think the Ganesh Datta Pathak edition is very clear, there are only 7 Karakas, nothing more and nothing less, and so on. Same with the manuscripts of Jaimini Astrology. Some of the editions talk about the Pitru Karaka. The shloka goes like that, Tasya Anusarana Amatya, that is the one next to the Atma Karaka in degrees is the Amatya Karaka. Then Tasya Bhrata, after similarly, lesser than that is the Karaka for brothers, the Bhratru Karaka, Bhratru Chara Karaka. Then Mata, Matru Karaka. Now some say after that comes Pita and then Putra, then Nati, then Dara. This is one of the opinions. Some editions talk about, they don't talk about Pita at all. They go to Mata, then Putra, then Nyati Karaka, and then Dara Karaka. So 7 Chara Karakas proper are indicated. And if we think of what the great Parashara said, that is natural, because if two merge, then Rahu will go somewhere. He will not have the Karaka for the 8th, because when you consider Pita also, then you get the 8 Chara Karaka nomenclatures. There would be nothing left for him to occupy. And if two do not come together, then he doesn't have a role to play at all. This has to be understood. Again, I generally think that nothing was done without reason and without logic. And since we know that Lagna is always supposed to be the Atmakarak Bhava, the as Bhavas Karaka, the Sun is a Karaka, Sun is Atma Karaka, and that is it. And then you, if you read Amartya, that is the Dhana, the money that was always, and the advice was given by the minister, Amartya. And then comes the Bhrata, the third house, we call it Bhratru Bhava, then the Matru Bhava, the fourth house, then the Putra Bhava, the fifth house, Nyati Bhava, that is the sixth house, and Tara Bhava. This appears to be more logical. I mean, of course, the learned are open to their own interpretation and understanding. I am just trying to tell my concepts, how I look at it. You apply it on the real life horoscope and find out for yourself. Now, there is another aphorism at the end of it. Now, that appears everywhere, that Matra Sah Putra Meka Sama Mananti. Some think that Matru Karaka and Putra Karaka are one and the same. If that is the case, then of course the fifth Bhava can take over the I mean, the Pitru Karaka can be indicated by the fifth bhava, because fifth is ultimately ninth from ninth, and ninth is fifth from fifth. So they are interdependent, or we can say secondary bhavas representing each other. So then that makes sense. But they are, whether Parashara or Jaimini, they say Samamananti, something that they merge. That means it is not their opinion. So this is what we have to understand. After that, we will go to the next step, where both say Saishte Bandha Moksha Yoho. This aphorism comes after the Atmadhika Kaladivir Navoga Sapta Nam Ashta Nam Va, and then Saishte Bandha Moksha. So he decides whether you are going to get bonded or you will be liberated, which means that planet has the authority to grant you something or even harm you, depending on where he is placed, what is his strength, and so on and so forth. That is more, you know, amplified by Parashara and others also, when they say ki, as the king, without the king's orders or desire, nobody can execute anything, even the Amartya Karaka. Similarly, the Atma Karaka is the king amongst the Charakarakas. So, this one has to understand. Now, another interpretation of this will be, since Atmakaraka is the Karaka for Atmabal, the self-confidence, if you don't have self-confidence, all other things may not happen. I mean, you might not be able to execute it. So, what is king? What is son? If we think about it, we will get the same answer. I mean, if we will see that when son is weak in the natal chart, then that person lacks self-confidence. Besides perhaps support of father or happiness of father, that is another thing, but you will generally observe this. And a person not having self-confidence may not be able to get the full potential that is promised by a chart. So this is the concept of Charakaraka. Understand this. The problem occurs is everybody has different opinion. I don't even deny the eight Charakarakas being possible, I mean the individual Pita and all those things, because Kalidas, when he talks about the Pada, that is the Aruda Lagna and Aruda Pada, which will come later on, that is another concept on which the sage Jaimini has talked much about or amplified. We see the great Kalidas saying you only should draw eight Padas and nothing more. The rest of the padas should not be drawn. So there are differences of opinion and there are many learned people who have commented on this thing from different point of view. So nothing is, it's not that, as we call, no Baba Vakyam Pramanam in Jyotish, because somebody has said that is the final, or somebody has written it is final. That is not how Jyotish operates. This is a Vedic science. It is open to interpretation. Shastrartha and Vad was the basic system of Vedic sciences. You had to convince other by giving certain examples or logic or something which is experienced, and then try to convince him. Nobody thought about it. Nobody thought bad about it. So this is how the sciences developed, and that is why you will find different opinions of different sages, even in modern times, different great astrologers, learned astrologers who are more into the Jaimini part of astrology, or who propagate Jaimini part more, because maybe because it is not that well known, so it is good to resuscitate to old sciences. But within them also there will be difference of opinion. Don't think that one understands less than the other. Everybody has right of his opinion. I don't remember whether I have told you, I am by training an engineer. So for me, results matter. And for the Jataka, it is results which matter. Our knowledge or our great knowledge doesn't matter. Even when I tell the somebody who comes for concern, I tell, I think this will happen. Let us see what happens. And if it comes true, it is grace of God and not my intelligence or anything. This is how the science is there. It's a साइंस ऑफ संभावनाओं का साइंस है, ऐसा मैं कहता हूँ हिंदी में. दैट इज आई ऑलवेज से दिस इज ए साइंस ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटीज, बिकॉज वॉट विल फाइनली हैपन विल डिपेंड ऑन द कर्मा डन बाय दैट पर्सन. कर्मा डजंट नेसेसरली मीन सम पायस थिंग और वॉट एवर, वॉट एवर एक्शन द राइट इज एक्शन दैट ही टेक्स और राइट एक्शन एट द राइट टाइम दैट इज टेकन बाय द जातका इज केपेबल ऑफ चेंजिंग द फाइनल रिजल्ट टू सम एक्सटेंट, नॉट टू ए ग्रेट एक्सटेंट बट टू सम एक्सटेंट विच इज मोर देन एनफ. सो माई फ्रेंड्स, इट इज नाउ 20 minutes आई सी, दैट इज वॉट इज द मीटर सेइंग एंड शोइंग मी. सो आई रेस्ट नाउ and I am thinking that I go to Arudapada, the concept of Arudapada in the next lecture. I have already told you I will not be giving some great, you know, tips or some complex yogas or whatever, but that I might take after the Arudapada and other things are over. Sthirakarakas, perhaps I will talk about Sthirakarakas as envisaged by Jaimini and I think, yeah, I'll do that and then we will go to the Arudapada. After that, maybe we will look at the way it is to be used. By the way, before I close this, I had promised you that I'll tell you when I use this. I use Chara Atma Karaka more particularly when I think that that person needs to worship some deity and is capable of doing that. Not all are capable. Being an astrologer, you will understand who can really do it with sincerity, who cannot. And at that time, when the Ishta Devata is to be seen, I do look at it from the Charakaraka point of view. How? I will tell you later on. Perhaps I would like to complete this basic structure first, and then in one or two lectures, I might talk about it. If you like it, do later on go on letting me know whether you like this approach to Jaimini astrology. The standard approach I have never taken, I will never take. You know that. That you have been with me so far so many days. And so my dear friends, thank you very much. And next week I think I'll talk about the concept of Arudapada and the differences in it. So, good night.